So it's important that you find some time to reflect on the year that you're just finishing up. So find some time that you can reflect on this year. And the first thing that you might want to do is make some notes while they're still fresh in your mind. Make some notes of major changes for next year that you want to make so you're ready to address them in August. Or maybe there's some things that you want to work on over the summer so that those changes are ready to roll out. Maybe you want to use Ready Rosie in your Back to Teacher or Meet the Teacher night. And so how can you work on that over the summer so that you're not doing that at the last minute? There might be one or two that you can work on over the summer, and then there might be some that you can start on in August. If you're like me, I always ended the year with a long list of plans that I was going to get done over the summer for the upcoming year. And before I knew it, it was August. And then I was starting the year already anxious and stressed because I didn't get any of the things done that I wanted to get done over the summer. So take some time to make some notes. What are those things that are important and really critical to you to get done? And then which things that if you get to them, that's great. If you don't, it's no biggie. Then think about some things that you can do to fill your well. Be curious about something that you wanted to learn more about for your craft, for your teaching, for your profession over the summer that you never have time to do over the year. Maybe you want to take some time to explore Ready Rosie and all the research and answer videos or some of the different modeled moments in your content area. Maybe you just want to read some books that have nothing to do with children or working with families. That's fine too. Maybe you've always wanted to knit or crochet. So what are some things that will refill you? Set two or three personal goals that you want to work on. Find a coworker who will lovingly hold you accountable for those goals. And they don't have to be huge, huge, elaborate goals. Maybe it's a goal that you want to work on your home and work balance. Maybe you don't want to take something home from school every single day to work on. Maybe you want to set a time to leave school by every afternoon or 3 days a week. Maybe your personal goal is to make dinner 3 nights a week. I don't know what those goals might be, but set two or three or one if you need to, and find someone who will help hold you accountable. Then plan a time to either daily or weekly to shut down, unplug so that you can recharge. I have friends who are device free from dinner time until bedtime, and they don't look at their phone, they don't get on any of their devices, they just have family and recharge time. Or I have a friend who does not use devices on Sundays. So whatever it is, if you can't go all day or you can't go for multiple hours, find some time that you can just shut down and unplug from our devices so that you can recharge. And then most importantly, even if you have a summer job or if you have small children at home or you're going to summer school, make sure that you are taking care of you. Remember, teachers need play and recess just as much as our kids do in the summer.